Good afternoon. First of all, I would like to thank the NIN to invite me to this important function because my institute have been working with NIN for decades. And our founder, Professor Ari Valayasevi, he is very good friend of Professor Gopalan. And both of them are more than 90 years old already. So I'm, and also in terms of policy. Recently, Thailand just announced to, that we're gonna be transfat-free country in January next year. So this is a thing that's very challenging to for us. Let's look at the transfat fatty acid first, what this look like. So it means that it is the double bond, the fatty acid that have double bond at the unsaturated part. So if you look at this configuration, the middle one is a cis, double, cis form of the fatty acid, of unsaturated fatty acid, that hydrogen are in the same side. So in Latin, cis mean the same side. And then trans is the location of the hydrogen are in opposite sides. So in Latin, trans mean opposite. So this is the trans fatty acid that is the in the lower one that you can see here. So in fact, in bacterial fermentation in the ruminant animals, so ruminant animals have four parts of the stomach, right? And one part of the stomach have the bacteria that can change the cis form fatty acid into the trans form fatty acid. So this one you can see, but how much it is in these natural products? Let's see. You can see that the part of, I mean the milk product that should be the most concentrated in terms of fat is butter. Right, so the butter can be ranged from 2% to 4 to 5% fatty acid, trans fatty acid. TFA means trans fatty acid. I put saturated fatty acid in here too, because it's not the trans fatty acid that is the, you know, the bad guy, but we also look at the saturated fatty acid as a bad guy also. So you can see that in butter, the most trans fat that you can find, not more than 5%. But in other products, for example, premium grade pasteurized milk that contain very high fat, already about 4% to 5%, is allowed about only 0.14%. In the beef, marbling beef that contain a lot of fat, is about 0.64%. Whipping cream, about 2%. So this is one that you find in nature and come from the ruminant, you know, animal products. The second part that can cause trans fatty acid in the products is the refined cooking oil. Refined cooking oil have the process that have to pass very high temperature at long time. So this one we call process deodorization to remove undesirable flavor out from the natural fat or oil. So at this temperature, you can see that if the fatty acid or the oil have more unsaturation bond in their molecule, they tend to have more trans fatty acid formation. In this one, you can see that the palm oil is so saturated, right? So they're gonna have the trans fatty acid about 0.38%. Rice bran oil is more unsaturated than palm oil, but so they have more monounsaturated and some polyunsaturated, so they get about 0.63 trans fatty acid. Soybean oil have so many unsaturated bond, so they have 0.81 trans fatty acid percent in per 100 gram of the oil. This is the second part or second source of the trans fatty acid that you can find in your products. The first one, natural one. Second one, refined cooking oil. So even refined cooking oil that you use at home, you're gonna find some of them, but not much. The third one, this is the worst one. This is man-made and intentionally made. So this is, we want to change the liquid, vegetable oil or fish oil, to be more solid and more stable in terms of the oxidation. So why we have to do that? In the country, temperate, in the temperate zone, like in US, okay, I said the US as an example, the natural oil that you can find in vegetable is more unsaturated. For example, soybean oil. Because in that atmosphere, the temperature is really low. So the oil in naturally need to be liquid. This problem we not find in the tropical zone, like in the south of India, or in Thailand, or in Malaysia, because the oil that we found naturally, most of them are saturated oil. So the temperate vegetable oil, they have low smoking point, and they also cannot be used for deep frying, especially used for produce puff and pie, or deep frying, french fry, whatever, right? So in the past, they have to use lard, because lard is very saturated. But if they want to use vegetable oil, how can they do it? They have to make it more saturated. But if they make what they call fully hydrogenated or make it fully saturated, it becomes solid, cannot be used. So they have to do it partially hydrogenated. So some molecule is saturated, they put hydrogen in there. Some of them not saturated. So this is called partially hydrogenated. And it have been used in the Western country for a long time. Most of them used in for what shortening. In the past, shortening we use a lot. So if you use the vegetable oil, you have to use partially hydrogenation. You can use oil for making different kind of a frying oil, deep frying oil, french fry, fried chicken, donut, margarine, even imitate cocoa butter in a cheaper price. Right, so this has been used for a long time. So you can imagine that the country like us in the tropical area, for the deep fried oil, we don't need to have the partially hydrogenation because we have the natural one. We use coconut oil for, I mean, almost 1,000 years, I guess. Yeah, and then we have the palm oil that come from Africa and in Malaysia, and then we have produced in our country. So for low income people, this kind of partially hydrogenation never come down. But the middle income and the high income, that they eat bakery products that come from the West, this product come in into this product of this socio-economic class. Why we are afraid of the trans fat? Because if you look at this study, right, they replace the first one, the first bar, replace saturated fat with trans fat for 1% of total energy intake. Second bar, the middle one, replace monounsaturated with trans fat. And the third one, replace polyunsaturated with trans fat. Cholesterol level increase after replacement, and then, I mean, in terms of LDL increase, and HDL decrease. So trans fat have double effect in terms of TBD. And you can see that the ratio of the HDL to cholesterol ratio is increased. So this is the effect that worse than saturated fat. And if you compare between saturated fat and trans fat, you can see that the dot one is the trans fatty acid, and the square one is the saturated fatty acid. This effect on ratio of LDL to HDL. So the more you replace, you can see a lot of study have done, you know, this is a review on the mini study. You can see that the effect from trans fat is much worse than saturated fat in all cases. So they said in meta-analysis found that it increased 23% in CHD or CADO, CHD risk, okay, heart disease. And also for by gram to gram of trans fat comparing with saturated fat, they have 10 times increase in terms of CHD risk. In some country, for example, in Denmark, they try to ban trans fat, and you can see that the death from CVD going down, from heart disease going down. And also in New York, when they ban it, the death from the CVD going down. In fact, different countries have different contexts, and the risk for the trans fat and saturated fat are different. This is, you can see that the one in square is Thailand. The green one is trans fat, risk from trans fat, and the red one is the risk from saturated fat. But if you look at India on the deck side, I didn't put the very close to Thailand on the other side. India, the intake of the red one, right, is for the saturated fat is not high, but the risk from the trans fat is higher. In Pakistan, very high in terms of the trans fat risk. Okay, so this is the, and if you look at the, in terms of the risk analysis ratio, the industrial trans fat cause very high risk, but the trans fat that naturally formed by in the ruminant, not so bad. But overall, trans fat also have the risk for the CHD. Okay, yeah. And the, if you look in US, right, they average, they take trans fat about 2.6% of the total carry, or about 5.8 gram. 80% come from artificial, and 21% come from natural. And in the artificial, among them that use, most of them are in the bakery products, and they also use at home also. So how much trans fat that we should not eat in excess? The WHO, FAO, the WHO mentioned that not more than 1% of the total calorie. So it should be about 2.2 gram per day, or not more than 0.44 gram per serving if we have 5 serving per day. And for the saturated fat, it's about 10 times. So it's about 22 gram per day, or not more than 4.4 gram per serving. Oh, this is the analysis in the in terms of trans fat in the food product, right? You can see that in the first column is the product that doesn't have trans fat more than 5.5 gram, and saturated fat not more than 5 gram per serving. That is a risk limit. And for trans fat more than 5.5 gram per serving is on the first the second column, yellow one, the first yellow, and second, the other one is saturated fat more than 5 gram. And if the combination is in the red color, so you can see that fried donut frying oil is one thing that you can find some trans fat. And also in the shortening, some product, you can find some trans fat. The fried donut, yes, is product of the making from the donut frying oil, you can find. And then pie and puff, chocolate, something, yeah, okay. So this is a product that you find to be the problem. Others, not much in Thailand, because for example, butter bran, right, after branding is not so much now. And then you have some, the chocolate and cheese, fried chicken, we can use the palm oil or coconut oil instead. In other products, I have some Thai showing here, like fried fish, french fry, dairy creamer, or pasteurized milk, premium milk that we shown already, not no risk at all. So in the country that we have tropical oil, the product that used to be for partially hydrogenation can be replaced by the technique that we call oil branding. You can use palm oil or coconut oil that fully hydrogenation mixed with the unsaturation. If you have more money, you can do the technique that we call interesterification or fractionation. And see, show you something. On the pink part, you can see that this is PHO, partially hydrogenation oil, yeah, right? Contain about 23% of the trans fat, or 46%. But after you blend it, percent of trans fat become lower than 1%. And the same as the donut that produced from the PHO and also the, you know, mixed oil, blend oil. So normally after you blend it and you use to replace, we have to be controlled in terms of the saturated fat that may be increased. So in some case increase, some case is not increased, so it depends on your formulation. And the control, in fact, in US are very active, you know, and then finally, in 2018, they banned trans fat from their own country. They have done a lot in many states. In Europe, mentioned about trans fat to be have to be less than 2 gram per 100 gram. You remember that in our refined oil, we got about less than 1%. So they can pass the European standard. In Thailand, we announced that we don't say about trans fat. We say about not allow PHO or partially heterogenation to be produced, to be imported, and to be distributed in the country. Okay, for the labeling, trans fat alone, nobody allowed to be labeled. If you look in the slide that I show quickly, in order to have the trans fat claim in Thailand, we still hesitate. We don't allow, because we have to look at the condition for trans fat, for saturated fat together. So it can be like a trans fat free, we should have both trans fat and saturated fat together as a criteria. Or otherwise, you have to claim like no partially heterogenated ingredient, that is the main source of trans fat, but you cannot claim trans fat directly. Okay, that's all. Thank you.
Thank you, Shish.
Trans fats, you put everything under one thing. But I want to know, what's the difference between a ruminant trans fat and that which has been partially hydrogenated by the industries? What's the major difference? Trans fat is trans fat.
The trans fat from ruminant is normally is consists of vaccinic acid. It's the main thing. Okay. And then we found that it's not doesn't cause so much risk. As I show you in this slide, maybe this one is more clear. But sir, the time is short, so I didn't leave it so long.
Thank you, Shish.
Yeah, 1 second, Jerry. Yeah. Oops, sorry. Oh, it's not in here anymore. Okay, yeah. So it's not so much risk comparing with the PHO. PHO have variety of the trans fat, you know, forming. But for the one that formed by ruminants, only vaccinic acid is the dominant.
Okay.